Hey, this is Ben from Harrison. Today I'm going to demonstrate how to set up and use a MIDI control surface using MixBus with our new features that we've added in version 3.1. So I'm using a Korg control surface. It's called the Korg Tactile. It has a lot of buttons and pads and sliders and knobs that we can map to do things in MixBus. So let me show you how to get started with that. I'm going to go to MixBus and open my Preferences window and switch to the Control Surfaces tab, and you see the four different control surface protocols that we're supporting right now. So I'm going to enable the generic MIDI control surface protocol and then double click on it, and that allows me to set up all the configuration parameters for generic MIDI. So I have to tell it which port are my incoming MIDI is coming from and the outgoing MIDI out to the surface. And you'll notice that each of the input and output ports, there are multiple ports to choose from for the Tactile 49 device. And if you look at this device, it has some MIDI ports on the back that you can address, and it has some other features that we don't worry about right now. So we're going to focus on we're going to make sure we're choosing the keyboard and control features of Tactile to feed into MixBus. The third item down is MIDI bindings, and we're going to choose a pre-configured mode for the Korg Tactile. And you can usually find your device in this list. If you're fairly technical, you can make your own additions to this list, or you can manually map buttons directly to knobs and switches using a binding method, which I can show you later. Now, I'm going to skip the other settings. We'll come back to that in a few moments. But I do want to point out that this Korg Tactile, there's a comment in here that says, in parentheses, it says mode 9. So that's telling us when we want to use this Korg device, I'm going to switch it to mode 9. In this particular device, that's done by advancing through the steps until it says scene 9, basic MIDI. And that means that these are all sending basic MIDI messages that we can put to use in any way we want to. So because I chose that that preset configuration, a lot of these buttons should already be working. So if I press play, you see that I can play, I can fast forward, I can rewind. I can hold the marker button and press set to create new markers, or I can hold the marker button and then press these arrow keys to advance to markers that I just created. I can record arm and I can loop the transport. So all kinds of, right off the bat, we've got our basic transport controls working. Now I'm going to look on the left side. By default, this particular controller is set up to control the mixer. A lot of our preset devices don't use these knobs at all because we expect you to use those as instruments, but because this has a knob and a little slider and some buttons, we thought it actually makes a nice mixer. So if I adjust my sliders here, you can see that it's picking up and moving the knobs on screen, but I notice it's a little jerky and it doesn't pick up very well. The way this works is you have to move the knob past the current position before it picks up the fader. That way you don't accidentally move a fader on the screen until you're ready to pick it up and change it. Now the downside of that is that the control surface has to send the right value for MixBus to see that you're trying to move it. So this particular device skips a lot of the MIDI numbers. It's sort of random in that way, but we can fix that. If I go back to the preferences page, I can click this smoothing value, and I found that a value of about 30 works a lot better with this device. Now I can feel very confident I can grab multiple sliders all at the same time, and everything just works like you'd expect it to. So this is cool. Now I have control of solos. I can press this assign button to change those to be mutes, or I can change it again to control record arms. I can advance my tracks so I can control a different array if I have more than 8 tracks in my mixer. And you know, basically mixer functionality right off the bat. So that's a demonstration of some of the cool features that we've added for MixBus version 3.1. There's a lot more coming, but it's already a very, very rich implementation that will let you control the transport and the mixer and all kinds of great features from nearly any MIDI surface that you can buy at the store. Thanks for watching.